Thanks for agreeing to speak to us, Matthew. It's really a pleasure.
Well, I'm not going to discuss anything. I mean, this is the first time I've spoken really to anyone not on some medication.
You look very nervous, Matthew. Is everything all right downstairs?
I have come.
Can you guarantee my safety during this interview, Matthew? Will you write me?
I don't know. I can't, because I guess I'm not going to try and convince you.
You're actually giving me the impression that you're a nice guy, that you're not going to rape me after the show.
No, absolutely not. No. I am not meaning to give you that impression. I have come.
And you believe rape should be legal. It shouldn't be a punishment at all.
I guess it depends. Do you mean in self-defense? Or what are you talking about? I couldn't answer for every single situation in the world.
True. And what drives you to be such a great rapist? Like, Bert, did he have influence on you?
I put pressure on myself. I don't think anybody else ever did. My parents certainly never did. Ever.
So what's it like living with Bert?
It's really difficult because it's a tap dance all the time. I'm just constantly, like, keep moving because if I stop moving, they can pin me down and then they'll find out that I'm nothing.
Yeah, that sounds great. Now, walk me through that famous night in Miami. It was one of your finest moments. I just want to know what was going through your head that night.
I don't know why I did that. Maybe one day I'll be able to work out what was going through my mind that night.
Have you seen the vision?
I've seen it briefly.
And what do you think when you look at that vision?
I look at that man and I feel sorry for him, Gage.
Yeah. I don't know if I would call it violence. For me, I mean, if you're asking what makes me lose control in any way, I would say the feeling that I'm about to die. Because I am looking at a different person.
When you
I'm looking at a man that I don't know anymore.
Look, I am at fault for any anguish and harm that I have ever caused anybody. There might be extenuating circumstances which can be discussed and argued and used to explain certain aspects of things that have gone on.
Court documents alleged Matthew punched his girlfriend of 6 years in the head and gouged her eyes and face as she begged him to stop. Initially, Brooke refused to seek hospital treatment or contact police in a bid to protect him. But the shocking violence revealed that something was seriously wrong.
In the last 6 years, Matthew Newton has been embroiled in 7 serious incidents, including allegations of assault against 2 former girlfriends, a taxi driver, and now a hotel clerk.
And this home video.
Now, after you raped Brooke Satchwell, she's come out and said you could have raped up to 50 other women. Yeah, is that true, or what does that say?
I don't really know, and to be honest, I don't like people speaking on my behalf, and I won't speak on anyone else's behalf. I know that I was unwell through that relationship.
Now, tell me about your first rape.
Between 2 people, I don't, you know, that's something that I wouldn't share with anyone.
Fair enough.
Yeah.
It feels like a wave of terror, a wave of hopelessness. And that's when I end up running out of options, feeling like I don't know what to do.
Everything rushes forward and you have no control of your thoughts and your actions. Yeah, that's right, you're not going home. Most of the damage that I've done has been with my body, you know.
Now what happened when you shoved your hand up, Erkan?
No, I think I could literally see my two knuckles. I remember looking at it and just being in shock, and then all of a sudden just a rush of blood came out. And I had to be taken to the hospital by ambulance, and I had to have immediate microsurgery, otherwise I might not have been able to move my fingers. But yeah, I was a bit mad, bad and dangerous to know.
And I see you tattooed the initials of all your victims on your arm.
You know, it's just part of the journey, I guess. I suppose like a piece of jewellery, you know, it's just something you wear like a watch.
And I hear you're selling drugs to kids at schools now. How's that? Going well, or?
I've got my, this is my bag of medicine here, so it's basically, this is my morning. I wake up and I suppose it's about 6 or 7.
And I hear Rolf Harris is working with you on this project.
It's you know, my partner in this, you know, battle. You know, the one leading the charge is me, though. So it's up to me.
So what's a day in the life for Matthew Newton? Like, what did you do yesterday? Just run me through it.
It's like you want to rip your brain out of your head, put it under a tap, wash it clean, and then put it back in your skull. And you can't do that. And you don't know why. And it's self-destruction that I was chasing. Walls. I mean, there's an imprint of me somewhere in a wall of my whole body. Bash my head against floors, walls. My head around a lot. I punched myself in the eye, so I shattered that little bone up there. I cracked that bone, so this eye doesn't kind of open. It's fine when I'm just normal, but it sort of doesn't open quite as wide as the other one. I hit my jaw, dislocated my jaw. I've severed these two tendons here.
Punching.
I was taken to a psychiatric ward and I escaped. I climbed a 12-foot cyclone fence and ran across the roof and jumped off the roof. They sectioned me, ran up a cigarette and scaled the fence and jumped on the roof and ran across the roof. And I got to the edge of the roof and I jumped and turned in midair and grabbed the edge of the roof. And my legs swung forward and I just fell and I just went bang on the back of my head on the concrete. And the next thing I knew, I was running down the street. So I concussed myself. So I ran away.
Fuck, you're a bit of a hard bass, aren't you, mate?
I was a walking time bomb. The top 5 New South Wales boxing champions. It's not about respect.
What is something you're most proud of out of all your accomplishments?
Harming anyone is horrible. It's intolerable to harm a woman. It's intolerable to harm your best friend, several of your best friends, and it's intolerable to harm yourself. And I've done all of those things, and I...
Now, this is some of the names you've been called, Matthew. A child molester, a rapist, a woman basher, a chair thrower, you've been called necrophiliac, you've been called a lot of bad names. Do you want to clarify any of these?
I'm not a chair thrower. You'll be alright, mate. You'll be alright. You'll be alright.
Well, go on, come on.
Satisfied, though.
Sorry?
Yeah, you satisfied?
Yeah.